Ladies and gentlemen, Mike the Hebrew Hammer Brown live from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. I know some people were under the impression I was going to be in Cincinnati. I am not in Cincinnati, unfortunately, for the game. Plans fell through. But I did fly to Philadelphia, PA, and I am staying at the McClure residence. Listen, we got a massive show today, okay? It's a big show. It's a big show for a multitude of reasons. First of all, we've got a couple of special guests. We're joined by one of them right now. We've got Brian McClure joining the show whenever. Okay, there he is. Hello. Oh, Brian. Good to see you. Hey, man, look. Championship Saturday. We've already got one guest in the queue.
What's up, Alex?
Listen, we've got – let's go ahead and bring him in right now. Because today's show – Alex, how are you?
What's up?
Listen, live from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, the goal of today's show – Brian and I, we want to talk to fans across – U of H fans across the country, okay? Today, we were at a – where were we? We were at a Christmas market. We had a great time.
We're at Love Square down in downtown Philly.
Yes, Love Square. What is your beer of choice, by the way?
You know, now that I moved to Philly, it's got to be the Yingling.
Yingling, brought to you by Michael and Brian.
You know, America's oldest brewery out of Philadelphia, or Pottsville, PA, right outside of Philadelphia.
Facts. Alex, somebody told me go Stros today because I'm wearing this. I want championship vibes today. I woke up today, and I feel most days like a champion, but today especially because U of H is about to whoop that ass. I'm just going to go ahead and say it right now. What are your thoughts on the game?
Well, it's going to be hard. Playing in Cincinnati is tough. You know, their fans are ruthless. Look, Cincinnati's a good team. I know you said they're not good, but
they
Cincinnati's
suck.
A good team.
No, they're not.
They're a good team.
No,
if
they're
we,
not.
I mean, they have a great
if we get if we can get to them early, I think we win.
Okay, Brian, what are your – I mean, an unbiased opinion because – wait, let me guess. Hold on. Where did you go to school?
Michigan State, if you couldn't guess.
Okay. He's a State fan.
Yeah.
What are your thoughts on the game today? I mean, Houston-Cincinnati. At Cincinnati, they're supposed to be this big, oh, my God, look at us sort of school. I'm not impressed.
Look, I mean, I'm looking forward for U of H to pull off the win. If for nothing else than a little chaos in the college football playoffs scenery. And I also just – I don't really want to see Cincinnati in the playoff. No offense, but I just don't think they stack up with the other teams that – you know, the Georgias and Alabamas of the world. I don't really want to see another blowout first-round playoff game like we've seen the past few years.
I just don't think they're good. I don't like –
I mean,
they're okay.
They're good.
There's nothing impressive about them.
There's no question that they're a good team.
What do you like about Cincinnati?
Fickle, I mean, I like coaching, honestly. It was where you start.
I think Luke Fickle turned down the Notre Dame job.
He turned down the Michigan State job last year, turned down Notre Dame this year.
Who would want to live in East Lansing?
Let's
be honest. I was kidding. It was a joke.
We came out on top on that one, but you know.
Yeah, that's fair.
Luke Fickle has the pedigree. His team is – this is the second year in a row that Cincinnati's been a top-notch team. I just don't think they have the horsepower to put up with the SEC or the other Power 5 conferences, to be honest.
But here's
like
the
Ohio
thing.
State even.
But they put chili on their spaghetti at Skyline. For that reason – outside of anything else, you can't let them get into a playoff.
I mean, that doesn't have nothing to do with the football. But,
yes, it does. Yes, it does. Okay, a city that puts chili on spaghetti, we cannot let into the college football playoff. Alex, as a member of the Jewish community, would you put chili on your spaghetti or no?
Yes.
Okay, that's disgusting.
I mean, let me just ask, like, what does it have to do with the Jewish community?
Yeah, Alex, what does it have to do with the Jewish community?
Well, we were
chili's not kosher.
Well, we were at a Hanukkah party on Thursday, and it's the sixth night of Hanukkah, by the way. Happy sixth night of Hanukkah to Brian. Phenomenal hospitality here. Let me tell you this.
To you as well.
Thank you. If you are in the Philadelphia area, look up the McClure's as a bed and breakfast. It is absolutely spectacular here. No one's going to look y'all up. I'm just giving y'all some free pub here.
You had miso soup?
We have a guest room that is always available if you are in town and you're a friend of Michael's. Feel free to hit us up.
My man.
Hey, Brian, I just booked my flight.
Hey,
You did that while on the show?
Yeah.
Okay.
Just let us know. As long as you don't have a problem with dogs, we're good.
I don't think that's going to be a problem for me.
Yeah, you are a dog trainer, so we should be fine.
So here's the thing. Getting back to the game today. Like, their quarterback, oh, my God. Look who's here. Alex, I got a special surprise for you. Let me tell you something. Here, live on Beer Sports, are now joined by, in all honesty, probably the greatest defensive end in the history of the Now, I do want to say that he did take his talents to Maryland. Okay, he is a Terrapin.
The Northeast, okay? Yeah. Where we're at.
No, I mean, for sure. That's not far from here. For sure. We are joined by Zeke Reiser live here on Beer Sports, whatever. Zeke, welcome to the show, first of all.
Did he go to Maryland prior to Big Ten or ACC time?
Zeke?
I was the last year in the ACC.
Okay.
All right. First of all, where are you coming to us live from?
Because I'm at my house in Houston.
Okay. Well, Alex and you are both in Houston, so we're going to have to kick one of y'all out. No, I'm just kidding. First of all, thank you for joining the show. Second of all, thoughts on today's game from an athlete's perspective, right? I don't think we lose this game whatsoever, okay? I don't think there's any shot in hell that we lose this game. But what are your thoughts, a U of H team coming in to Cincinnati? Hopefully they stayed away from Skyline Chili because it's disgusting. Where do you think the Cougs are today?
So first of all, I've heard mixed feelings on the Skyline Chili aspect of it. I've heard some people, it's like, oh, yeah, it's good. Like, once you understand what it is, and then other people just say that it's terrible. So as far as the game is concerned, so, like, from my perspective, I played in two conference championship games, which we were, I believe, favorites in both. Definitely we were against Southern Miss. And I believe we were my freshman year against East Carolina as well. And we lost both games. And so, I'm hoping that some of that, like, kind of takes, you know, a turn in our direction as far as the good luck is concerned. But I think the biggest thing is that they have to kind of do what, I guess, Houston Cougars as a whole have done, you know, our entire careers, our entire lives, our entire, you know, entire time we've been in school. And then thereafter, it's, you know, come back and be the underdog, no matter, even if we're favored. So I think that's going to be a really big part of it is, you know, it's going to be rowdy in Cincinnati. I mean, they're, you know, a college football playoff team right now, but they have to go in there and do what they've done all year. I think putting pressure on the quarterback is going to be huge. But then also, you know, keeping a steady pace on offense. I think, you know, as far as the offense is concerned, any struggles that we have been seeing have been, you know, whenever we can't get the easy stuff done, whether it's picking up blocks, you know, making the easy throw, making the easy catch. I think if we just play solid offense the entire game, I think our defense is really going to be able to take it to the next level, but just control what we can control and kind of go from there. But don't let the game get bigger than what it needs to be, if that makes sense.
I don't think I could put it any better myself, Brian. I really don't.
No, I mean, my question would be like, you know, does preparation at all change for like a championship game like this? Or is it, you know, status quo? Same.
So the only thing I could really suggest is make sure that your head coach isn't leaving during the preparation for the game. Because that, believe it or not, is a big deterrent. But
it's another day.
Oh, no. Oh, no, he said it. Oh, but, God. I didn't want to be the one. But
you know, as far as the game in general, no, not really. You know, I know that we have some guys that have been banged up, you know, especially the past couple weeks. But just making sure that, you know, you're not being too predictable, whether it's on offense or defense. And then always have, you know, little wrinkles that you're going to throw in every week that, you know, they haven't seen before. They're not going to be prepared for. But I mean, just because it's the conference championship game doesn't really change anything. You just have to make sure that you're mixing it up and you have to be even more dialed in than I think what you would say like a week one game. But other than that, no preparation really changes as far as an overall thought process is concerned.
I want you to know a couple things real quick. Number one, I do have the Zeke Reiser jersey live here in Philadelphia with the the Robertson last season patch on it. It will be live at the watch party today. So I want you to know it was brought to Philadelphia. It is live in Philadelphia. It will be present in Philadelphia. Number two is Die Hard, a Christmas movie, while we have you. And number three, who would you take in a street fight, Clayton Tune or Desmond Ritter? And I'll hang up and listen. I appreciate your
Dang, what was even the first question? Go back to the first one again.
I don't think the first CTE one was a question.
No, the first one was more of a statement that there is a Zeke Reiser jersey live in Philadelphia.
Yeah, I mean, I think that's great. I think there should be more of them. You know, I need to get a kind of a backtrack, like NOI contract type deal. I know it's a small market. It's a very niche item, but I think we should definitely get those more in production so that we can, you know, definitely spread those out across the country more. But
I'll have to look at
it. What was the next one?
The second question is, it's that time of the year. First of all, happy sixth night of Hanukkah.
Thank you.
Now that you're a member, you and your wonderful wife, members of the Meyerland community, happy sixth night of Hanukkah to you.
Yeah, it's everywhere. There are menorahs aplenty, so I definitely appreciate it.
Okay. Michael was really upset that at the Christmas festival we went to today, there was no menorahs.
There was no menorahs!
Well, I mean, is it a Christmas celebration or a holiday celebration? Because
well, it was a Christmas festival.
It was specifically Christmas. Then I you know, you can't really Christmas. Get that upset. It's like, okay, there any Kwanzaa stuff? I mean, let's be real.
It was brought to you. It was brought to the city of Philadelphia by the Germans. So I'm not shy, but it was nothing Christmas or Hanukkah related.
It was a
I should
German
say.
Christmas festival, basically.
It was a decent time. Yeah. The second part is Die Hard, a Christmas movie.
I'm going to first of all say yes, and then I want to follow it up with, is Harry Potter a Christmas movie, and or is Harry Potter a Halloween movie?
What?
Wait, all of them.
What?
And so the reason why I ask that is because there are Harry Potter marathons, I feel like, during both periods of time, but fair. I think it's just because, like, witches and wizards are more of, like, Halloween, but nothing... I mean, in the storyline, it also has Halloween relation. But in Christmas is concerned, just a lot of the main plots and stuff like that happen during Christmas time. And so they get played often during Christmas, but are they actually Christmas related?
I do want to say that the third Harry Potter movie starts in the winter. It's snowing around Christmas time, so you could argue it is a Christmas movie.
No, we went to this entire Christmas market. There's not one Die Hard thing related there. What are they doing?
But there was a Harry Potter themed bus.
Yeah, congrats. You
so
know what?
It is Christmas.
Let me tell you something, Zeke Reiser. All right, you tell me. You get me to a Christmas market with a Die Hard themed bus, and I'm there with bells on.
I have seen like the ugly Christmas sweaters with like Bruce Willis's face and stuff on him. So,
Alex, would you wear that?
Yes, I would in a heartbeat.
Okay. Zeke, let me ask you this. First of all, Don calling in from Fort Lauderdale, big fan of yours. My two questions for you. Number one, what are the three songs you would have on your playlist for championship preparation? Number one. And number two, give me an official prediction for the game. I will hang up and listen.
The three songs, like hype music type songs.
Yeah, what gets you hyped before the game?
Yeah, I've always wanted to know that. What are the guys listening to?
I mean, nowadays.
So as weird as it is, I don't know if it's necessarily like a hype song, but I know that it came up a couple times. It might have been during the 2011 season where "Party in the USA" was like a good luck song Miley Cyrus. Oh, but yeah. It's not really a hype song, So, like, we were struggling playing Tulane in the Superdome, and then whenever we came out of halftime, they were playing Party in the USA by Miley Cyrus, and, like, we knew that that was, like, bam, like, that was, like, the catalyst that set us up for success in the second half, and we blew them out in the second half, so. That's number one.
Such a bizarre thing, but that's awesome.
I mean, I'm here for it. It's a banger. Like, okay.
Really, for me, it was really anything by Drake. Drake was a big one for me, which I think probably the equivalent now. Not that Drake is like out of touch or old school or anything like that, but anything by DaBaby is probably going to be
what is that,
pretty
DaBaby?
Big.
Who is that?
Are you serious?
It's another rapper.
Okay, well, no, Michael. No, if it's not Neil Diamond, If it's not, DaBaby. Great. All right, I'm gonna go look.
And then I don't really have a third one, but
your parents.
Have you seen the movie Friday Night Lights? The movie, not the TV show.
Yeah,
absolutely.
Okay, so the song that they run out to before they play Dallas Carter in the movie.
Oh yeah.
I don't know what the name of it is, but I know that it was it went super hard, especially like my senior year of high school ish. We had it playing like before every game, so that's not necessarily college level, but that was a really good one. It was kind of like a screamo rock song, but it went hard.
He was like, they were like, lock up your chin straps. We've got East Texas versus West Texas. We got championship football, and then he runs through the big, you know, whatever.
Yeah.
Yeah, I can't think of it either. All right, so give us your official prediction for the game. What happens today in Cincinnati, University of Houston, against the Cincinnati Bearcats?
And it's really tough, especially with them playing at Cincinnati. But I'm going to say Cougars are going to get out big in the first half. Cincinnati is going to mount a comeback, but I say that Houston's going to hold them off, and Houston's going to end up winning by 3.
Ooh!
Wow!
So kind of like the Baylor game right now, where Baylor came out real strong in the first half and just got to hold off Oklahoma State.
Yeah, so you know you automatically think like, oh wow, this is going to be a huge upset, and then you know the higher ranked team proves, okay, that's you know why they're the higher ranked team, and so they're like, oh, don't think so fast, and then we just stop them just short and end up getting it done by 3.
So if we win today, would you give Dana a lifetime contract or no?
I wouldn't do anything for a lifetime.
Okay. Also, what do you mean by you stop them? What are you thinking when you mean you stop them and win by 3? Like they're driving at the end of the game?
Yeah, I think that's probably going to what it's going to come down to is like a 2-minute drive at the end of the game to put them over, but like we end up getting like a pick or a fourth down stop, and we end up closing them out at the end, win by 3.
Shutting down Ritter at the end of the game.
Yeah.
This is a 2-part question. One for you, Alex, first, and then you, Zeke. When we win tonight, will either of you be lined up at Academy as soon as the game is over for championship t-shirts and hats or no?
I filled up my gas tank today on purpose just for that.
Okay. Facts.
Zeke, I will be in San Antonio this evening, and so I do not believe that they will have any U of H fan apparel in sight, but I will pay the extra shipping and or resale prices of whatever apparel that I need. So
okay.
That's usually my default just because I'm not going to put in the footwork for it. So whatever.
This is a very important question. When you add that cart together, you're going to get the t-shirt. Are you going to get the hat to go with it?
I'm not a big hat guy.
Okay.
Just because I have a very large head. And so that kind of throws things off. But yeah.
Okay. Will you be getting the championship fanny pack?
No, not a big fanny pack guy either. I appreciate the utility of a fanny pack, but me myself, no.
Will you be getting the championship magnet to put onto the refrigerator?
I would consider it. That's not that bad.
Okay.
But definitely T-shirt. T-shirt, like, by far.
So I have a question.
Especially if they somehow throw a Jordan brand logo on it. I'm all about it.
No, Jordan brand magnet. I'm here for it.
The Jordan brand football gear is just
– yeah. Oh, I mean, so interesting. They can put whatever they want to on that shirt, and I'm going to happen. Also, by the way,
yes.
You guys know, like, the Sac Avenue – type stuff like for the defense and stuff like that. DeAnthony, number 44, I've actually hit him up on Twitter being like, hey, you need to take advantage of this. And so they have like some major merchandise coming in the future. I'm not saying it's going to be like Jordan brand merchandise or anything like that, but they're going to be putting out like a full line of, I guess, like t-shirts, hoodies, hats, stuff like that.
It's a Stack Avenue on it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Like with the street sign or whatever.
Yeah, so I'm going to need an autographed Zeke Greiser one for the garage. I'm going to go ahead and put that out for now.
Deal.
Look, we've been neighbors for how long? We haven't done the bagel shop one time yet. I'm a little upset by that. I'm a little taken back that we haven't gone to the New York.
The new bagel shop or the old one?
It doesn't matter. I haven't been invited to either. I'm more than happy to foot the bill and make it, you know, a tax write-off for BSW.
Can I come?
No, you can't, Alex.
God damn it.
Okay, Zeke, I'm a little upset by that. That's the first thing. Brian, did you have a question for Zeke Reiser?
I do have a question.
Okay.
So, on the opening kickoff, you said you need U of H basically to start out hot to win the game tonight.
Marcus Jones, baby!
If you win the coin flip, do you take the ball or you defer in a game like
this? It's tough because especially to come out hot, and you know, obviously whenever you have a great kick returner, that's your automatic thought. But I'm always a fan of deferring to the second half. I just like being on defense first, because if your offense stalls right away for whatever reason, or you know, you turn the ball over or something like that, then your momentum is actually killed. But on a defensive standpoint, if they score, you're going against the other team's script, which are going to be their, you know, favorite 12 to 15 plays that they know are going to win, because they're, you know, that's why they've already scripted those out. And so I think it hurts your momentum more if your offense stalls or turns the ball over to begin the game, rather than if the defense gives up a score. So that's just my philosophy.
That's interesting.
Yeah. Are you a fan of when a defense gets a turnover, the entire team running to the end zone to take a picture with that stupid camera in the end zone?
Yes and no. I think I was more of a fan of it whenever it was like first happening, but now I think it's a little overplayed. But I don't know. I don't hate it. I'm not upset by it.
Okay.
But you do agree though that after a pick like that, you should go for a home run if you're in their end.
Yeah, no, but I don't agree with running to the end zone.
Like immediate no. Home run ball after you get a big turnover.
In all honesty, if I got a big sack or a big turnover, the way I would celebrate, I don't know about y'all, I would go get a chair from the sideline, and I would hoist up the individual that got the pick or the turnover, and I would do the horror where,
that's awesome.
It's never been done before in a collegiate or an NFL game. That's how I would celebrate.
I don't know where they have chairs
on the sideline.
I know the NFL has like more lax terms on like celebrations and stuff like that, but I know like in college, it's not necessarily the same. Like they, in theory, are going to throw more flags for like celebrations and stuff like that. I was scared to death whenever I was playing that I was going to get a flag for like celebrating or something like that. So, but they, I mean, now they let them get away with a lot more. I think especially like because the turnover chains and, you know, belts and all that stuff have become a bigger thing. I just think that is carried over into like the field of play, and they just let them get away with a lot more now than like what they did whenever I was playing.
Right. I feel like in college that's the case, but in the NFL nowadays, they clamp down on just anything.
Well, I would
they
get
call it taunting.
Yeah, the taunting penalties in the NFL now.
That's ridiculous. I mean, we could talk for another hour about how ridiculous the taunting penalties are, but
I would get a religious exemption for doing the horror on the field. Like that's not what I'm worried about. True. What was the coolest celebration you ever did that you didn't get flagged for?
That I didn't get flagged for? I didn't really celebrate a whole lot. That's the thing. I did like this awkward chest bump thing after I got a sack at Tulsa my freshman year. But it's because like I got up and I was like, oh crap, I'm here by myself. I don't know what to do. So I did this weird chest bump thing. It was weird.
Wait, with who? Like by yourself?
Kind of, yeah. Like I was like beating on my chest. It was lame for sure. I don't think I really had
You're not one of those guys that like scripts it ahead of time. Like if I do this, this is going to be my celebration. It was more
thing.
Did you ever practice anything in the mirror? Be honest with me.
No.
Be honest with our viewers. Did you ever practice a celebration in the mirror?
No, but I will say, so you know how I said that, like I was always worried about getting a penalty and stuff like that.
Yes.
Philip Stewart would do this thing where after he would get a pick on somebody or something like that, or a sack or a big play or whatever, he would literally like jump up like 40 inches in the air and then like stand over them and like celebrate right over top of him. And I felt like there was a couple times where I had to like pull him off of whoever he just made a play on, because I was like, I would have bet money that he was going to get a penalty for unsportsmanlike conduct or whatever it was. But I never really put that much thought into it, but I think I'm a lot more emotionally driven now. Is like whenever I first got done playing and I was coaching, and then now as a fan, I think I'm a lot more emotional than whenever I was like playing for whatever reason.
Alex, what's the snack beverage outlook at your house for today's game?
Well, I'll be going to Ryan's house, so we'll see what we have there.
Okay, then I digress. Zeke, you said you're driving during the game?
So I may be driving possibly during the second half, but I'm actually like in the process of putting up my Christmas decorations and lights and stuff like that on my house right now. So I'm not going anywhere for the foreseeable future.
I have one last question.
Yes.
How do you feel about a Notre Dame team making the playoff? Should Houston beat Cincinnati today?
Win.
And Oklahoma State clearly looks like they're going to lose. How do you feel about a Notre Dame team that has a new head coach making the playoff? Do you think they'll actually put them in?
I mean, it's tough with Notre Dame because I always get flashbacks of like whenever they were last in the – I guess they were last in the national – I don't know if it was 2012 maybe, whenever they were in the national championship. And they just got blown out. And it was like embarrassing. And so I just keep getting flashbacks of that. And so like forever, they can go undefeated in the regular season or, you know, as good as they can be. But I always have like PTSD from whenever they got absolutely blown out by, I think, Alabama in like 2012 or something like that. It was the Manti Te'o invisible girlfriend game.
Yeah. The fake girlfriend.
And so from that point on, again, they can be a great regular season team, but I mean, I'm always going to be kind of tainted by what they did in the past in the national championship. So not a big fan of them getting into the playoff.
We are getting breaking news here that it looks like Baylor's about to blow it.
I haven't seen that.
Zeke, Mike,
also, just let you know, there's another head coaching position up for grabs. Presbyterian just fired their head football coach.
Okay. Zeke, do you have any front runners that you believe to be in the lead for the Presbyterian job?
Maybe Zeke wants the job.
I was thinking that you may like step in there and get into coaching. I don't know, but
Here's the thing.
That's really my only guess.
Yeah, the last thing I was going to ask you was, do you honestly think I could have played the linebacker position at the D1 level?
No, not whatsoever. but I think
what about the JUCO level?
Like, I think with most, like normal sized people. Is that anybody can go in and try to kick and be like, oh, yeah, I'm a walk-on kicker, and then never have to kick in a game. I think that you could have snuck in there.
Wow. What about safety?
No.
Come on, Michael.
All right,
I don't know what your 40 is, but I don't have, like, really high expectations. So.
Wow. Okay.
Mike is the Cowboys assistant.
No, listen. In all honesty, I ran about a 4.6 40.
No, okay. 4.6? No way. 4.6. Maybe a 5.6. Maybe.
Mike ran a 4.6 in his dreams.
There's no way you ran a 4.6 40.
In all honesty, it appeared to me, in my honest opinion, it felt like a 4.6 40 when I ran it. If that makes any sort of difference.
No, so the fastest 40 I ever ran was like a 4.72.
Jesus. You ran a 4.72?
Yeah. That was in the spring. Before the 2012 season, like right before summer workout, like we got out for the summer and stuff like Ooh. That.
Oh, we lost him.
That's legit though. A 4.7 240, Brian.
Yeah, and you try to say you could run a 4.6.
I did run a 4.6.
When?
I don't know. We lost Zeke here momentarily.
Were you on rollerblades?
No. Okay. No, it's ridiculous. What's that? No, we lost you there for a second. Brian was making fun of the fact that I ran a 4.6.
You try to say he ran a 4.6 when you ran a 4.72 as your fastest. I'm just going to throw it out there that there's no way you're faster than him at any point in your life.
Yeah, probably not.
Like I'm probably the slowest I've ever been right now, and I know for a fact that I could beat most people. I know that you're not most people, but I could beat most people right now. Than the fastest like they've ever been in their lifetime.
I think we may have to set that up. Like a 40-yard dash.
A 40 run.
I'll 100% pull my hamstring.
Oh, okay.
Just a heads up.
Well, okay, so you're saying that now.
And he would still win.
Yeah, in all honesty, Zeke could probably pull his hamstring and still beat me in a 40. One elbow jab, I feel like I'm out of the race.
If
like,
we want to get into our recent betting history, I'll definitely take Zeke and I will do something.
ever since I've arrived in Philadelphia, I've made three bets. I've lost all three of them. Like, I'm not betting you anymore. Zeke, we've taken up enough of your time. You're a rock
star. Zeke, what do you think? Zeke, what do you think the final four will be?
Ooh.
The final four?
Houston,
of course,
obviously. We have Ryan.
I'm going to say that Georgia's going to win. I'm going to say Georgia, Alabama, Michigan, and
Houston.
Cincinnati if they win today. But if not Cincinnati, then Notre Dame.
So you think Alabama gets in even if they lose?
Yeah, I think so.
Really? Wow. With three losses? It would have what?
It would be two losses.
Two losses.
Yeah, but they're still Alabama. Who did they lose to earlier in the season?
A&M.
A&M.
Which A&M isn't a terrible loss, but if your second loss is to Georgia, then
yeah. So then is it a rematch in the playoff, 1-4?
Ooh.
So I think it'll be Georgia 1.
Well, I guess we got to start there. Who do you think wins the Georgia Alabama game?
Georgia. Georgia.
Okay, so he thinks so Alabama's so out.
Alabama would have to be the 4.
No.
Yeah, so I think it's Georgia 1, Michigan 2. I'm going to say somebody it may be Cincinnati at 3 if they win today. Maybe like a Notre Dame and then Alabama at 4.
Ooh.
So I think the first college football playoff 1-4 is going to be another Georgia-Alabama.
So Georgia-Alabama part 2.
So yeah. Kind of like a replay of Alabama-LSU from what year was that? A
couple years ago.
2016 or whatever.
Yeah, playing in the conference championship and then playing again in the playoff.
Yeah, a
couple of games ago. Before we wrap up, Zeke, we ask all of our special guests their favorite pizza in the city of Houston. Where is
favorite pizza?
Favorite pizza in the city of Houston.
Oh, easy, Romano's.
I agree with you, Steve.
Romano's.
No, Romano's.
Romano's. Yeah. Like Ray Romano?
Yeah, it's like on West Gray.
Okay.
It's also J.J. Watt's favorite pizza place in Houston. Okay. Fun fact.
What are your thoughts on Star Pizza?
It's good, not great.
Okay, that's fair.
I'm not mad at it. There's a place kind of over by my house, Fuzzy's, that's pretty good.
Yo, Fuzzy's is solid.
Fuzzy's is excellent.
Yeah, hey, we're overdue for a Kenny and Ziggy's corned beef pastrami mandate. So,
yeah, let's do it. I need some matzo ball soups here pretty soon.
Oh, you moved to Meyerland for 3 months, and all of a sudden you're throwing out terms like matzo ball soup.
Dude, I'm like half Jewish at this point.
Wow, Ziegreiser is now half Jewish. Hey, Joe Cooch, thank you for joining the show. We love you. You're fantastic. Let's get it done today.
Let's do it. Go Cougs. Thanks, guys.
Yeah, brother. Appreciate it. You got it. All right, look. Hey, look. Fantastic. We got Zeke Reiser. All right, we got Zeke Reiser, Alex.
Yeah.
Yeah, so who is Zeke Reiser?
Defensive end extraordinaire. Phenomenal.
Former University of Houston Cougar football player.
Okay. I mean, I'm sorry. I lived in Houston, but I didn't really follow Houston football.
That's fair. Listen, in summation, big game today. Yes. Massive game today for the Cougars. All right. I've been talking a lot of smack on Twitter over the past 24 hours. Okay. I think we win today. I don't think we lose today, Brian. I swear to you, I do not think we lose today.
I mean, like I said, I'd love to see it. I'm curious to see how Cincinnati comes out. You know, they got everything on the line for this game. It really, to me, is how you start the game. If it starts like the Baylor-Oklahoma State game, I see UH pulling it off. But if you let Cincinnati get off to a hot start.
That's fair.
It could get away from you quick.
It's fair. Alex, before we wrap up, thoughts on the game, just real quick, and give me your official prediction.
So if our defensive line, which is monster, comes out, shuts down Desmond Ridder, I think we win. But if Desmond Ridder comes out and throws two or three touchdowns right off the bat, I mean, I think it's going to be close. I think the final score is going to be 31-24 Cincy.
31-24 Cincy. To answer your question, Steve, I am in Philadelphia. I was supposed to be in Cincinnati, but things got resituated, and I'm very blessed to be here in Philadelphia with Brian and Adrian. This has been episode 170, Alex. 170 episodes of Beer Sports Whatever. Very fantastic. Joined by Hail State himself. Can I call you Hail State? Is that what
y'all do? Yeah, I got my Spartan Dogs for Life sweatshirt on.
What is a Spartan Dog for Life?
That's what our alumni call ourselves, you know, Spartan Dogs.
What is the 13 for? Is that the year you graduated?
That's the year I graduated and got the dog on this. If anyone is interested,
I need that sweater without our alumni.
So support the Michigan State alums. But
Do me a favor, go ahead and place an order.
Once you go to Michigan State, you're a dog for life.
Yeah, it's fantastic. I'm very happy for you, Brian.
I know you're mad about the Mel Tucker hire, but
I'm not mad. I mean, we literally have talked to all things. I mean, Zeke Reiser joining the show basically took the direction directly with him, which is great. I mean, the fact you get an ex U of H player on the day that U of H plays for a title, pretty damn cool.
Oh, absolutely.
This has been episode number 170 of Beer Sports Whatever. Make sure to check out BSW on Apple Podcasts and Spotify. Check out Around the Block on Twitter at @ATB_network. Check out my Twitter, BSW_Podcast_MB. I will be live tweeting the entire game live from wherever the hell we're going to watch the game.
Xfinity Live.
Xfinity Live here in Philadelphia. We got Eat 'em Up Cougs from Eric Bishop. I haven't given my official prediction on the game. We win this damn game by at least 3 points. I would say 4, but I like...
Michael, go for it.
No. Shut up, Brian. Look, at least 3 points the Cougars win today. I have felt this by a field goal. U of H by a field goal in Cincinnati. We win the game today.
You make the game winning?
All right, Mike, if U of H wins, you go streaking in Philly.
What?
If U of H wins, you're going streaking in Philly.
There's a good chance I will be streaking in Philly. Yeah, absolutely.
Brian's like, no, you're going to get arrested.
But you guys make a game winner to win the game, or do you hold them off at the end of the game?
No, we hold them off at the end of the game.
So you get out up early and you hold them off.
Yeah, we got to get a good table wherever we're going. It's going to be understood that we are rooting for the University of Houston. We are a University of Houston vibe right now in Philadelphia. We are holding it down. If you're watching this show, the millions of listeners we currently have, if you're in Philly, look me up. We're going to watch the game at Xfinity Live.
Let's do it.
Whose house? Cougs house. Bay Bay. That's what I'm talking about. Cougars. I feel good. I feel really good about that.
Let's get it.
Let's get it. We will see y'all next week. Oh, big announcement here at the end of the show. BSW will be live for episode 171 Thursday at 8 o'clock, I believe. I will confirm the time with Alex Mayhem Middleton of 94.5 The Buzz for our Christmas movie bracket extravaganza, Lollapalooza extravaganza. More details to be published tomorrow. Y'all have a great day. Go Cougs. It's 3:09. OU still sucks. And the Houston Astros are and forever will be your 2017 World Series champions. Thank you to Brian McClure for joining the show today. You've been a wonderful co-host. I'm going to tell you that. In all honesty, you had some great questions. You did a phenomenal job.
I appreciate it.
I think Brian should take over the show.
In all honesty, if I were to pass away at any point in the near future, Brian would probably own 86% of Beer Sports, whatever, Alex.
Hey, I mean, I appreciate being on. I think this is my second time. Second. I appreciate the opportunity to come on here.
Hey, man.
And Zeke was an awesome guest.
Zeke was fantastic.
He gave some great insights on, you know, the preparation that goes into a game like this.
Adrian was here. We're listening to Party in the USA in the car on the way over. There's no way we can't.
Oh, absolutely.
Oh, Adrian. Oh, there's Adrian.
I got it queued up right now.
Party in the USA is going down. I'm going to put on the U of H sweatshirt. Y'all have a great weekend. Whose house? Cook's house. Baby! Yep. Da-da-da, da-da-da. Love you, Alex.
Bye-bye.
Playing at LAX.